हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल सब्जेक्ट गुरु। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डील कुछ एक्सरसाइज 5.3 क्लास 10 मैथमेटिक्स अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1-3 एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन फोर पार्ट्स। Now we will discuss question number part number 5 of question number 3. So without wasting time, let's see 5 parts here. First we will write here, given we have d equals to 5, sn equals to s9 equals to 75. And we need to find out here A and A9, isn't it? We need to find here two terms, first A and second one A9. So here we can see it is given Sn, S9. So we use the sum of first 9 term. So we know very well, we put here, we have Sn equals to n by 2 inside the bracket 2a n minus 1 into d. Now we put the value of n, we have 9. So we can write here 9 over 2a, a as it is, the value of n is 9, and the value of d we have 5 here. So we can put the value as 9, 75, 9 over 2a, after subtracting 1 we get here 8 multiple 5, isn't it? Now we multiply to the other side, 75 multiple 2 over 9 equals to 2a plus 40, isn't it? Now how can we solve it? We can take 3 here, 3 2 6, 3 5 15, and 3 3 9. So finally we will get, after shifting we can shift 40 to the other side, 50 over 3 minus 40 equals to 2a, and finally we have after taking LCM 50 minus 120 over 3 equals to 2a. So we have 0, 7, 3 multiple 2 equals to a. So we divide 35 times. If we divide 2 by 70, so we will get 35 times. So we have a equals to negative 35 over 3, isn't it? It's our first answer. Now move to next, we need to find out here a9. So how can we find? We can easily apply the formula of an, and we know very well. Also we can write here also, so a9 equals to a plus 9 minus 1 into d. We can apply here the formula of nth term. So the value negative 35 over 3 plus 8 multiple the value of d we have 5 here. So 35 over 3 plus 40 over 1. So we will take LCM as a 3 minus 35 plus 40 multiple 3. So minus 35 plus 120. So what will we get? 5, isn't it? And 11, 8. 85 over 3, it's a 9 term, isn't it? So we have here, so we can say the value of A, we have negative 35 over 3, and the value of A9 we have minus 85 over 3, isn't it? Now you can solve fifth part. Now we will move sixth part. In sixth part, we have value given A. So A equals to 2, D equals to 8, SN equals to 9, 90. So we need to find out here N, and thereafter AN. So let's see what should we do. You can see here we have SN. So first we need to apply the formula of SN. So we can say right here we have SN equals to N by 2 2A plus N minus 1 into D, isn't it? So now we do not have the value of N, we have only A and D. So first we need to find out the value of N. So the value of SN we have 90. We need to find N. The value of A we have 2, and there is no value of N. So the value of D we have 8 here. So we can take cross multiplication. 2 will go other side, so we have 90 multiple 2 and bracket 4 plus 8 and minus 1. We can take out 4 inside the bracket, so we will get 4 and 1 plus 2 and minus 1, and 4 will go to the division in of other side, and 1 plus 2n minus 2, isn't it? 4 and 2, 4 j 2 5 j 10. 45 equals to n 2n 1 and 2, we have here 2n minus 1. 1 is positive and 2 is negative, so we will get negative 1 here, and then we multiply n within bracket 2n square minus n, isn't it? So what will we get here? 0, 2n square minus n, we shift 45 to other side. So finally we have 2n square minus n minus 5, 45 goes to 0. Now we have a quadratic equation. So we will factorize this equation. How? We have here 45 and 2. So we multiply 45, 2, so we will get 90. We see that sign is minus, isn't it? So 95 such factor after subtracting, we will get 1. So we can easily write here, ten minus nine. So we can write here 10 minus 9. After multiplying 10 by 9, so we will get 19, and subtracting we can get 1. There is a 1 here. So now 2n² - 10n + 9n - 45 = 0. We have two terms here. First term we take 2, because 2 can divide by 10 by divided by 2. So we can take here 2n, so n minus 5, and in this term we have got 9 as a common, n minus 5 equals to 0. So we have n minus 5 and 2n plus 9. So we will take n minus 5 equals to 0, and other side we can take n plus 9 equals to 0, isn't it? So n equals to, we have 5 here, and if we take here n equals to minus negative over 2, so it is not possible, because number of terms can never be negative. So we can leave this term. So our required answer is n equals to 5. Now we need to find out an. So now take a screenshot or pause down. So now we will take an term. Let's see. It is very easy, because we can apply only formula here. An equals to n minus 1 into d. So now put the given value here. We have a 2, and n we found 5, and what is the value of d? 8. 2 plus 4 multiple 8, so 2 plus 32, we have 34. So an equals to, we have, or we can write here, f5 equals to 34. It's our second answer. Now move to second part. Move to seventh part here. In seventh part we have AANSN. So it's just like question number fourth, part number fourth, question number seven, same as part number four. You can do yourself, try. We can write here, try. Now move to question number 8. Question number 8, we have SN, AN, and we have given only D. So how can we solve it? Let's see. Only we have AN equals to 4, D equals to 2, SN equals to minus 14. We need to find out here N and A. So we have AN and SN. So we apply only AN and SN first. So we can draw a line here, isn't it? So first we have AN, so we can put here the formula of AN. AN equals to A plus N minus 1 into D, and put the value of AN. For the value of A we need to find out here, and also we need to find out the value of N, and the value of D we have 2. 4 equals to A plus 2N minus 2. We multiply 2 within bracket, so we taking shifting 2 to the other side. 4 plus 2 A plus 2N, so we will get 6 equals to A plus 2N. It is our first equation. Now move to SN. SN we have 14, so we apply the formula of first N term. So SN equals to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D, isn't it? Now we can write here the value of SN. What is the value of SN? Negative 4, and we need to find out N, and the value of D we have here 2. We take 2 as a cross multiplication, so N 2A plus N minus 2N minus 1. Now we do not need here cross multiplication, because 2 we can take 2 inside the bracket. We take 2 here out from the bracket, so we have A plus N minus 1, and 2 cancel out by 2, so minus 14. Minus 14 equals to A plus, we have 2N here. So what should we do? We can get here N inside the bracket A plus N minus 1 into. Now what should we do here? Be using this is equation 2. This is equation 2. Now we can take out the value of using equation 1. So we take here A equals to 6 minus 2n. We separate A in a term of n, so we get here equation 1. So using equation 1, put the value of A in equation 2, and bracket, what is the value of A? We can put here 6 minus 2n plus N minus 1, isn't it? Now we can take minus 14 equals to, and we have inside the bracket negative 2n plus n, so we can get here minus n, because minus get 2n and n, so we will get n, negative n here, minus 1. Now multiply n within bracket, 6n minus n square minus n. First we solve inside the bracket. We have here 5 minus 6 minus 1 equals to 5, 5 minus n. Now multiply inside the bracket, 5n minus n square, negative 4. We can shift both the value to the other side, then we get n square minus 5n minus 14. Finally we got here a quadratic equation. Now we can factorize this equation. So before that, post down, and other way we can take a screenshot. Now see, we do the factor now. Factor of this term, we have quadratic equation n square minus 5n minus 14 equals to 0. 14 such factor, after subtracting we get 5. So 7 2 ja 14, then we can easily get 5 equals to 0. N square minus 7n plus 2n inside. If you open the bracket, sign will be changed. We know very well about that. So we have two term now. So we can take in first term n as a common and second term 2 as a common. So we will have here n as a common, n minus 7, and in other side, other term, we take 2 as a common, n minus 7. So we will get here n minus 2, we take out n minus 2, other side, not other side, out the bracket. So we will get here 2 and here n plus 2. The remaining part we have. So now n minus 7, we can separate both the term, n plus 2, so n equals to, we have 7, n equals to 7, the value of n we have 7, and n equals to, we have negative 2, so it is not possible, because number of term can never be negative. So we will get here the value of n 7. Now we need to find the value of a. So how can we find, tell the value of a? From equation 1 we have the value. From equation 1 we have the value, equation 1, what value we have? 6n a equals to, we have from equation 1, we have a equals to 6 minus 2n. So we can put the value of n, put n equals to 7 in equation 1. इक्वल्स टू सिक्स माइनस टू मल्टीपल सेवन, सिक्स माइनस फोर्टीन, सो वी हैव इक्वल्स टू माइनस एट. दिस आर आवर रिक्वायर्ड आंसर. एन इक्वल्स टू सेवन एंड अदर वे इक्वल्स टू माइनस एट, इट्स रिक्वायर्ड आंसर. इट्स आवर रिक्वायर्ड आंसर. Now move to question number 9. Question number 9 is very easy. You can do yourself question number 9. We will move to question number 10 now. In part 9, in question number 3, 9 part we have here, a equals to 3, n equals to 8, s equals to 192, we need to find out the value of d. So we can easily apply formula of sum of first n term. We can apply the formula of Sn, then we can easily find out the value d because we have a, n and s. So there is a no need other value in Sn. So we can apply the formula, then finally we get the value of d. Now it is try, you can do yourself. Question number 9. Now we will discuss part 10th. We have here in given last term 28 we have sum we have 180 144, they are total 9 term, there are total 9 terms, so we have the value of n 9, so we need to find here a. It is very easy question. Total term we will get here 9. So now we need to find out a. So we have three formulas of Sn. I can write here Sn equals to n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d, isn't it? And other formula we have Sn equals to n by 2, a plus l. So this is the short formula, and we have L and S and we need to find A. So we can apply second formula. Now Sn equals to, we have n by 2 A plus L. So the value of Sn 144, value of N 9, and value of A we need to find, value of L 28, isn't it? Now what should we do here? We can multiply, cross multiply of this number 9 over 2, so we will get 144 multiple 2 over 9, and a equals to 28. 9 16 ja 144, isn't it? So we will get here 32 equals to a plus 28. We shift 28 to the other side, so we will get here 32 minus 28 equals to a. Then a equals to, we will get here 4. The value of a we have 4. So we have done third question. In third question there are 10 parts. Now we will move question number 4. How many terms of the AP 9 comma 17 25 must be taken to a given sum of 63 in question number 9. Question number 4, we need to find out how many terms. So how many terms, it means we need to find out n here, number of term, how many term, we need to find out here how many terms. And we have AP here, AP we have 9, 17, 25, so on, must be taking, giving sum we have here. We can write in bracket 636. So we need to find out n here. So in this question, we have a first term 9, common difference we have 17 minus 9, we have 8. Now we can easily apply the sum of first n term. We have s equals to, or we can write sn equals to n by 2 a plus, sorry, 2 a plus n minus 1 into d, isn't it? Now we can put the value of Sn we have 636, and the value of n we have, there is no value of n, we need to find out value of a 9, value of d we have 8. Now we can solve it. So we have here n equals to 2, 18 plus 8 minus 1, we can 2 as a common inside, so we can write here 2n equals to 9 plus 4 n minus 1, we take out 2 within bracket, inside the bracket 2 to the 1, so we will get here 636 equals to n 9 plus 4 n minus 4. So we will get here 636 equals to n minus 4 n plus 5 we have here. So we will get 636 equals to 4n square plus 5n, isn't it? Now finally we will get here a quadratic equation. What is our quadratic equation? We have 4n square plus 5n plus 5n minus 636. We can shift here, we can shift 0, 4n square plus 5n minus 636, or we can write here 4n square, 4n square plus 5n minus 636 equals to 0. Now we can factorize, because we have got here a quadratic equation. So first we multiply 636 multiply 4, we have 2544 such factor after subtracting we will get 5 here. So now we can factorize. First you need to pause down the video. Now we have the factor here. We have 4n square plus 5n minus 636 equals to 0. After multiplying both the term, we will get here 2544. We can factorize. 2 and 2, 2 7, 2 2 6 3 6 2 3 1 8 2 1 5 9. Now we have 3. We have 5 3. Now see 2 2 4 4 2 8 8 2 16 16 3 16 3 48 and 53 minus 40 have we have 5. So we can take factor here 53 minus 48 and minus 636 equals to 0, isn't it? Now what should we do? We can take here 4n, 53n, minus 48n, minus 636 equals to 0. We have two term here. So what should we do? We can take n as a common, 4n plus 53, and other side we can take 48 and minus 53, sorry, my n plus 53, we can take 0. Now we can same term we have here, so we can not take 4. We can take 4 as a common. 4 as a common, not 4, 16 as a common. 16. There is no division of 16 here. So what should we do? We can take we can divide 4, 12 as a common, 12. So we can get 12 as a common. So inside the 4n we have 4n plus 53, we can take out, and inside we have what, n minus 12 equals to 0, isn't it? Now we can separate it. After separating, we have 4n plus 53 equals to 0. In second term we have here, what will we have in second term? We will have n minus 12. So n equals to 12 is our required answer. Why? Because if we take n here, negative 53 over 4. So negative 53 over 4. Number of term can never be negative. Earlier I told you. So we have the value of n here 12, isn't it? Now this is question number 4. Now move to question number 5 here. In question number 5, we will do question number 5 in next video. Thanks for watching this video.